A while back, I got thoroughly teed off with the fact that I couldn't use my fingerprint to get into Windows. It kept on asking for a password or PIN or whatever they call it. Basically, the code that I'd set up and wouldn't accept my fingerprint, even though I've been using a fingerprint with mobile phones for years without any problems. And I use it with Google, same fingerprint, same device, same computer, and usually 9 times out of 10 it works with Google. But with Windows, 6 times out of 10 it wasn't working when I tried to start it up. I was being forced to use my password, which I didn't want to do. I don't like passwords. And I hate the idea that they can be grabbed, whereas I think it's more difficult for them to use my fingerprint. I may be wrong. I restarted the computer. I got it. I made the stupid mistake of believing that when it said the backup would include my personal data, I stupidly believed that it was telling me the truth. And I crashed the computer. I reset it, got Windows to recreate the device. And since then, everything has gone wrong. Well, things like Mojave, that's the desktop video grabber, stopped working for a while and demanded I input a code that they'd sent me months ago that I didn't know anything about. When I found it, they wouldn't accept it. Had to go back to them. Lots of problems. It's been extremely difficult, and I wouldn't do that again, despite the fact that it's still not accepting my fingerprint. Anyway, one of the problems I've been having is that my printer has stopped working completely. It doesn't work at all. Nothing. And it says that this is because the spooler is corrupted or not working. So I'm trying to add the printer again to start out again, see if that'll work. And what I'm getting is add manually refresh. Anyway, I'll go back. So we'll do printers and scanners, add device. And it goes round and round and round and round. I don't know why it does that. So the printer that I want isn't listed. Well, how do they know? They didn't list anything. Anyway, add manually. I don't know if you can hear what I'm doing. I'm click, 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 add manually, add, refresh. I can't. Add manually, click, 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 add manually, nothing. So, let's not allow Windows to set my default and then see if we can still no, nothing. Click, 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 add manually, no. Download drivers, add manually, no. So, now this is an interesting one, help with printers and scanners. Let's try troubleshoot. Now, detecting problems. This is an interesting one because troubleshooters have moved and this tool will be retired. We could try learning more while goes through the process. It is really interesting to learn more. Depreciation of Microsoft support diagnostic tool. I don't know if that's American, it ain't English. Microsoft is retiring the Windows Legacy Inbox troubleshooters. Big deal. Begin redirecting some of the troubleshooters to the new GetHelp troubleshooting platform. Well, this doesn't help me. I don't care. All I want them to do is, if they're moving it somewhere, let me have it. Anyway, whilst we've been doing that, the troubleshooter has been going on. Operation could not be completed. The remote procedure call failed. You know, that's fucking useful, isn't it? So completely kiboshed, cannot get access to my printer, and I think this is a hack. Now you may think it's the incompetence of Windows, and lay down a great curse to the ancient Bill Gates. I don't.